Hello guys and colleagues. I welcome you to this webinar. Mr. Hans will be taking us on Miracle of Colors. You can understand colors. Colors is about sheet taking. It's very relevant to our work. A lot of aesthetics is involved in our work, and color is an important aspect of it. Mr. Hans from Germany will be taking us on Miracle of Color. He has done a lot of work in this area, and he has been in practice for so many years. You will enjoy this session with him, and I believe that as he takes us on Miracle of Colors, we will have a lot to take home. Mr. Hans, please.
Yeah, hello, my dear colleagues. It's a great, great honor for me to have you on the other side of the world, on the equator downwards. And my name is Hans Joachim Burkhardt, and you feel free to call me Hans. I'm in the business now since 46 years, and I did a lot of lectures and interesting things due to my life. But it's the first time I'm doing this in form of a webinar. And so far, it's something new for me. It's a new experience. And it's also my first, no, it's now the second contact to the African continent. And it was some months ago, I asked my colleagues, what about the colleagues in Africa? Where are they? I have not any contact to the African colleagues. And finally I found you, your group, and I want to share a bit of my knowledge. Maybe, hopefully it's not the last time you want to listen to me. And if you agree, I just would like to start my presentation. It is, we will talk about colors, about the basics of colors, how colors work, what we can do with the colors. And finally, I told you, I will tell you about the difference in your area to Asian area and European or North American area. There are some differences, and maybe you understand something. I hope so, you understand something and get something new. Here in Germany, we actually have the same time, but we have totally different conditions. We actually have -2 degrees, and it's snowing outside a little bit. It's frozen, and you have it nice warm. And that's what we are about. And about my person, I'm 64 years old. I'm father of 3 daughters. They are high school master dental technician and an artist. So we have all in the family. That's about my private things. And I would say, if you agree, I start my presentation right now. Is it okay?
It's okay.
It's okay. So we do the first, and I have to, sorry, does not work. I have to share my screen, right? Or is it shared? No. This one is to share.
Okay, great.
Now we take this. Is it okay? You see that?
Yes, okay. I can see it.
I have called my presentation The Miracle of Colors, because there is also always a secret in the colors, how they work, how we can manage the shade, and everything is a little bit secret. And the first one I found, this was this nice guy. It was Johann Wolfgang von Goethe. He is a poet and an artist. He was a poet and an artist. And he was the very first who watched the nature from another point of view. And what he found out about the colors is fixed in his writings in many, many years ago. It was in 1810 when he did the first research about what are colors doing with us. And he brought the color circle, and this color circle is exactly the same what you see right now on the screen. There are all colors in the circle that are possible to see with our eyes. We have over 60 million different shades to see, and we don't really know how they work together. This is a schematic of the color wheel. His color wheel for sure has much more in between these different colors, much more things to see, to show, yes? Anyway, in the wheel, you find any color you expect. Now I have a little problem. I can see the right side of my text because your pictures are over that. You're nice guys. There is absolutely no rule how many colors are to shown on this color wheel. So we reduced it only to a few colors to explain what is happening there. And if you see outsides of the wheel, there are the colors are lighter and insides they are getting darker. And you can say if the more you are outside, the lighter it is, and the in between in the center point you will find black. Outside is white and inside is black, and in between that everything else is possible from light to dark. Okay, let's do the next. Let's take the colors separately. We have three primary colors. The colors are yellow, blue, and magenta, or red is called. So with these three colors, we can mix every other color we want. And also you see it's from bright to dark. The farther you go in, the darker you get. We put it in these three segments, and all the combinations of any color we find in the nature is made of these three colors. So I make jokes. If one is telling me the wall is green, the grass is green, do you find in these basic colors any green? No, there is no green. The green is a mixture of blue and yellow. So if you get told the ball is green or the grass is green, no, it's a mixture of yellow and blue. That's a difference, you know? And also these others, these are the secondary colors made of the primaries. If you take blue and red, you get violet. And if you take red and yellow, you get orange. So these are the secondary colors made of the first primary colors. And every in between, every shade you can get is a mixture of all these three colors. If you see the circle, the painted circle, you see all these six colors that are basically made of these three basic colors. And you see the further you go in again, the darker you get, and the further you go out of the circle, the brighter you get. Now let's play around with the colors. And this is a computer animation. It's always the same tool. You must imagine, I took the wheel and turned it round. Yes? I from the upper tools, I just changed the on the lower left side, I changed it to the right. And on the other side, I changed it to the left, to the blue one. Yes, from the red one to the blue one. And this is what happens, always the same tooth. Also the next one, I changed the chroma. I took out color. This the upper is the standard. The lowers are reduced the color. So you get on the right side, you get it black and white. And on the left side, you get an intensive, more intensive. This is what we call chroma. If, for example, if your dentist tell you, yeah, the color is not fitting, it's too bright. You can ask him, what is it? Is it the chroma? Or what else? Is it the color? Is the shade? Or is it the chroma? That's the difference. You see? A tooth that does not fit in the mouth has two possibilities. Either it's chroma or it's the shade. If the shade is not fixed, is not well, we get a major problem. Okay. Let's take the next. Now it's the value. The value means brightness. Yeah, we have on one hand, the upper also is the original, and the lowest, the both are more light or less light. You see, if you put in more light, the same tooth looks brighter. It looks brighter when if you take out the light, if you switch off the light, it's dark, right? Yeah, the colors are influenced by the light. No light, no color. What I said right now, if you switch off the light, you will not have any color anymore. What we see in the mouth is reflected light. It's coming, if the light is coming from outside and it's reflected from the surface. That's what we see, yes? We don't see the color. If you stay in a dark room, the wall can be white, but you don't see it, yes? Because you have no light. And also what I have written here, if the carpet can be red or can be brown, but you don't see it. No light, no color. That's it. Okay. We say in the night, all sheep are black. And that's right. We don't see any color, right? Okay. Now we have relationship in between colors, and that's important for us dental technicians because we can manipulate our shades if they don't fit. Any color, if you see the black line, it's going from blue to orange. You can turn the line wherever you want in the circle, and you always will meet two opposite colors, and these two opposite colors equalize each other. So, for example, if you have a tooth that is too much orange, you can put some blue over that and you get a reduced of the orange. It's going down, but the trick is fantastic, but you must see, if you do that, the line is going through the center point and this one is black. So every color you manipulate this way will be darker than it should be, yes? So. What can you do with that information? If you have a tooth, for example, that is too bright, you can mix one of these pairs to reduce the brightness. Yeah, you can overpaint it that all. Always opposite colors, doesn't matter in which direction you put it on, equalize each other's, but it's going through the black point. You get a grayish tone. Now we have harmonic colors. If you look in the nature and you find something interesting, if you find something harmonic, you always will see the line is going through the opposite, yes? And you have a triangle. Everything what is in the triangle is harmonic. The other side, outside of the triangle, is a disharmony, yes? So what we want to have is, on one hand, we want to have harmonic tooth shades. We want to have it a harmonic build up. It must fit, it must look pretty. But on other side, we want to have characteristics. And these characteristics you will find on the other side of our triangle. If you put this picture, and I will give you the picture of the lecture afterwards so you can print out the pictures yourself and put it on your desk, and you always see what is possible, what can I do? What color can I use for characteristics? And how can I cut out these triangle and put it on the table and play around with it? That's what I did. And I had it on my computer and turned it around and was looking what is going on with that. And you can put it on a table and have a worksheet and can exactly see how you can manipulate your tooth color. Okay. Yeah, we have some optical phenomena. These are, for example, you know, the topic transparency and translucency. What is the difference? You must see, transparency and translucency is not the same. Transparency, if you have, for example, you have a glass, this is transparent. You can see what is in. This is water in. But you also have translucency. I have nothing prepared with translucency. Translucency, you can see the light, but you cannot see what is in. Yeah, that's a difference. It's like a milky glass. Okay? That's the difference between translucency and transparency. And if your dentist says the transparency is not okay, stop. Is it translucency or is it transparency? Translucency can be any color shade, for example, any color, maybe a blue enamel. Transparency is clear. Yes? Next thing, opacity. The opacity is you cannot look through an opaque maybe a tile on the wall. You have white tiles on the wall in your lab. Can you look through? No. It's covering the surface completely. So what happens if you put opaque on your metal frame? Metal is blocked by the opaque, so you cannot see the oxides, or you cannot see anymore what is inside. You don't see the frame. Okay. There is a microphone open. Okay. So, but if you have the opacity, the opposite of the translucency. Translucency, you can look in. Opacity is blocked. The lice is completely blocked. You will see if there is a noise around. If you have if you have a metal frame bridge, you have an opaque inside, and what is happening? The light is coming in and is reflected by the opaque. That's why you see, in this example, you see that the margin is a little bit painted, and incisal also is a little bit painted. That's why you see the colors coming out. The color is, in the nature, is always coming from the inside. It's not rarely laying on the surface. It's mostly coming from the inside. So it is a good idea, I think, to put the color inside. So what is happening if you bring the opacity to the surface? It's looking like a piece of bone. There is no color anymore because there is no reflection. So that means if you want, for example, if you want to have intensive color in coming from the inside, you must not use opaque dentine. You must use intensive dentine to bring more color to the surface. If you put the light in, it's reflecting, it's going through times through the material, and it's coming back more intensive, right? Now we have opalescence. Opalescence is an effect where we have a real crazy noise there. A reflection, a refraction of light that is done by some materials. You see inside the materials, and this is, for example, this orange line at the tooth. It's always the same tooth. I have shown you before the teeth with the colors. It's always the same. It's only one tooth. But what it means is these particles are refracting the light. That means they take a bit of the light, one bit of the light they take out and show you the other things only. Yeah, and opalescence is you find in the nature very, very often, but it's very difficult to bring it in our ceramic system. Yes, our ceramic mass, especially the high ceramic masses, are very difficult to bring in these Opal systems. I think the opals are coming from Africa, right? So, fluorescence is if you put light, a special light, on any material, and it's sending back another light. You see, you activate with a fluorescent material, you activate by light. I don't know if you have discotheques with black light in your country. I have no clue about your country. But sometimes we have the problem, we have patients, they get a couple of teeth, and they come back and say, hey, I was in a discotheque in the black light, my teeth are black, you don't see the teeth anymore. Why? Because our ceramic systems are missing the opalescence, some of them. On the other hand, other ceramic systems have too much opalescence. If they open the mouth in the discotheque with a black light, it's bright white. So both is not fitting exactly. Okay? That's important to also in the layering. I'm thinking about if the light in your environment, for sure at the equator area, it's the light is different to North Europe, for example, yes? It will be different. There will be different radiation in the light. So maybe this could be a problem you should notice. Some good examples of fluorescence are these LED lamps. These are nothing else. They get a radiation by the electricity and they begin to shine. Yes? Any questions? If you have any questions, please say.
Yeah, I think we'll reserve that at the end of your presentation.
Okay. Yes, now we have additive and subtractive light. Additive means we have three light sources from different angles, blue, in this case, green and red. And if you mix them all together, you get in the same portion, you get in the center, you get white. This is, for example, done with a television. Yeah, your television or your screen here is working with additive light. That means three sources of light, three LEDs are together in the same amount, are giving a light spot, a white spot. Yes? There where the colors overlap, you see, for example, green and blue overlap, what you get, mint, and the orange and the green, what you get is the yellow. And also, you can also do with this about 60 million colors, with this mixture. Subtractive light is working different. You have a white light and take off by a filter different radiation of the light. So if you take all out, you get black. Yeah. If you switch on off your switch off your complete light sources, you get black. That's what we have in the printing, for example. You have if you print a sheet of paper, you are working exactly with this system. You have your magenta, you have your yellow, and you have your, what is it called? Cyan. Cyan is it called. And with these three colors from your ink printer, you can add them together to get the black one. And the intensity of these three colors, how much you put on, this is made by the letter key, K. That means you have cyan, yellow, magenta, and key. And this is CIMK, is the standard printing colors for every book you can read, for every sheet of paper you have. Doesn't matter if it's an ink printer or laser printer or a printed book, nothing else, okay? So, what can we do with the tooth color? The right the right picture is my wife. The left picture is a patient. What for me it's important to say, it is not possible to say the tooth has a color. And for me, it's not possible to measure the color. Why? The tooth has several layers. Each layer has a different material. The enamel is a different material to the dentine, right? Every layer has a different translucency or transparency. And this point is, in my opinion, an important point for your region, because your teeth have another transparency. That means that the ceramic mass made for Northern Europe may not work in Africa because the teeth are different in the structure. The teeth basically are the same, but the color is and the intensity of the enamel is influenced by my wife, sorry, geht grad nicht, is influenced by the light and by, no, it's not influenced by the light, sorry, I was disturbed, is influenced by your life, by your food, by the water, drinking water, anything else. You have different minerals, for example, to North American or to North European, or maybe also to Australian. You have different conditions, and these conditions, the mineral conditions, are fixed in your teeth. Yes. So any layer has its own chroma and color. You see, the intensity of the color is different in any layer, and in the single layer you can have different colors. If you can have different colors in the dentine, so the color impression also, if you see a color, it's depending on the angle you look at. If you look from the side, you see more the enamel layer, and if you see it directly from front, you see basically nothing of the enamel. You see a different color. So if you turn it around the patient and look it from the side, for example, you can imagine, especially in the incisal edges, you can imagine how thick the enamel is. So, and if you, I will give you an example. If you have a tooth color A3, so, and you look separately your enamel, there can, in between there can be a 3.5, but the complete impression is A3. What does that mean? If the dentine is 3.5, it means that the enamel must be brighter than normally for A3 would be, or it is, the thickness is different. Other thing, if you have a bright dentine, A2 for example, and you have an impression of A3, the enamel must be more orange. Yes? So you can imagine what kind of enamel must I take and how thick I must build it up. Now, it is called our dentist to say us what dentine color has the tooth after preparation. Very important for veneers, for example. In my opinion, it's not possible to say this is a tooth color like that, because the tooth is living. And if we are doing crowns now today, tomorrow we will have different conditions, and we will have, in 10 years the crown will not fit anymore because the natural tooth has changed and our crown not, right? That's why I say it's not possible to sect one color only. We need the dentine color at very first. And the only who can give us the dentine color is the dentist. Normally we have no access to our patients in this stadium. Mostly they come if it's too late. If the color does not fit, they send us the patients instead of sending us before to see what is going on. Every layer has a different translucency and transparency. And any layer has its own color and chroma. The color impression changes by angle of view. That's what I said before. And below you see a picture. It was we took the color in my lab, and I said, yeah, it looks like a D3. And now look, the crown on the model, it's looking totally different. But finally, it fits. Yeah, that's the result. I think it's too sparkling a little bit, but basically, we got a acceptable result. Not more than acceptable. We can, if we have the same words, the dentist in the office, I don't know if you get the patients to see, but if we take this, if we speak the same language, if we know about translucency, if we know about opacity, and these words are common with the dentists and for us technicians, we have a language to communicate. And we have a language to write it down also. So every dental assistant, if she is speaking the same language and if seeing the same things in the mouth, they can transport this knowledge with the right nomenclature to you in the lab. So you do much easier to get it fixed because you have the same language. And what is not possible, in my opinion, are these machines. It's wasted money because if you want to have, if you have a car, for example, and you want to know what color that is, you can take this surface measurement. But this is not looking inside, it's looking on the surface. Yeah, it's throwing light in and the light is coming back, but what is in between, he doesn't say. Yes, so our eyes are important for that and not these machines. Save the money, take the money and go for holidays, for education holidays, for example. It's right. Yeah, now we have a very interesting thing. This is the window of a church. And this is nothing else. The light is coming from outside, and what you see is the inner side, the window from the inside, yes? Every of these small window pieces is a color filter, yes? Now what happens? We have here, we have all the colors in this photo, what is possible in nature also. So if you put the light through that window, what will happen on the other side on the white wall? It will probably happen that you see all these colors separate, but I think more, it will be a white color coming on this other side, because every color is in there. Yeah, it is. Yeah, it is a color filter, but it's a multi-filter. There are all colors we have to we can see. Okay, now I want to invite you for a interesting thing. This is the last what I will say. Afterwards, we can have the discussion. Just enjoy what you see now. It is a very unique thing. It's a commercial I found in the internet. And enjoy it. Just enjoy it. Shut up. Okay, dear colleagues, I think I haven't found anything more beautiful like this video to explain how magic colors can be. Probably you will not have seen any snow or anything like that before. I think it's if you come to Europe one day in winter time, it will be cold for you. But that's what we can say about the colors. And I hope you enjoyed what I have seen. And feel free to ask me now the questions you find and you have. And I will give you the link for the presentation so you can repeat that a little bit. Thank you for listening.
Thank you so much, Hans. And this has been interesting presentation. Honestly, I know my colleagues will share the opinion that we have never been taught this way before on the subject of color. And I tell you, it's been so insightful and very, very interesting. The lecture has been very, very, it's an eye-opener. It has opened our understanding and reflected far more than we have ever thought of on colors. I really appreciate this, and I believe most of my colleagues here too do appreciate this. Most of who are students, some are practicing professionals. I see that you have been able to open us up on colors. Our practice here, we most time use stock teeth to make our dentures. And I know what you're talking about on colors here is not so much about using stock teeth. It is about using all this acute material to prepare your fixed appliances. I guess I'm right.
Yes.
Yeah. Okay. So I think because when you're taking, you're using stock teeth, normally our practice here, you use a shade guide, which the clinician will have written maybe a number representing the color, and he moves that to the lab, and the lab technologists also look at the equivalent, look at his own shade guide, and try to match the colors. That is what we do mostly here. But when it has to do with our crowns and bridges, I think you have taken us beyond the basics of colors. We have really understood better now that light is what shows the colors. When it is dark, of course, you can't see anything. So the color you see is a reflection of light that the amount of light that is in your environment. So anyone who wants to work with color, we definitely have to get an illuminated environment. I will leave you with some of my colleagues who may have questions to ask you. I will ask my questions too.
Okay.
So any of our colleagues here, please go ahead. Any question you want to ask Hans about colors?
Yeah, I have a question to ask, sir. Can you hear me, sir?
We can hear you. I would appreciate if we can take it one after the other.
Okay. I think I'd like to go first. The question I have is on chroma 16. Hans made mention of...
hard to understand everything.
Sorry, let me mute everybody now for a while. I did that before, and we had decorum, but now.
From the meat water.
Please, if you are a participant here, you are distracting with the noise we're hearing at the background. Please try to minimize noise. If you are here for this session, please remain strictly to maintaining some noiseless environment. Please. Okay, Mr. Amataya, can you go ahead?
Yeah, thank you very much, sir. The question I want to ask is on chromatic staining. He made mention of something during his presentation that, Mr. Hans, that there is a difference between color and chroma, and of course the value of what you're trying to put together.
Yes.
Now, the question I want to ask is on chromatic staining. we get to realize that chromatic staining actually affects the outside, that's the external color you see on the restoration, be it zirconia, porcelain, whatever it is. So what basically is chromatic staining? We know chromatic staining has to be something that has to do with the internal coloration of the restoration, but we get to see the effect on the outside. That's the outer color of the restoration. So please, I need you to throw a light on chromatic staining.
Yeah. You remind probably this window. This is nothing else but what we do with the chromatic staining. We put it on the surface and do a filter. And I try to explain what is happening on the other side of the room with the white wall. Okay. Nothing else happens with a chromatic staining. If you put it on the surface, the light will go through and will be reflected from the white underground or from the So you modify the reflection by a filter. You put on a filter over there. But this is risky, I think. This has two problems. The first problem is a mechanic problem. It will get brushed off after a while. So if you brush your teeth, the surface painting will get off. And afterwards, you will have lost your color filter. And if the teeth are getting elder, they change the color. And they may change to the same direction, but normally they go in another direction. So your tooth, any day, will not fit anymore. It's going slowly, very slowly, and we ourselves don't notice, but our people opposite to us, they see it immediately. Yes? It's a slow process. So, in my opinion, it's better to bring the right color inside and cover it with the surface with a thick enamel layer by layering them. This painting, internal staining, it's called. This is a perfect way to get the right color.
Okay. All right. Thank you very much. So that's very much possible in zirconia. Am I right?
Yes, of course.
It's possible in porcelain, but not in acrylic.
It's also in porcelain. It's I must check if you have find it right now. Let me see. Maybe I find it.
Okay.
Probably I will find it. I don't know where it is actually. Robux. Color theory. No, I can't find it. Let's do that next time. I think I will do another presentation also, so we can do it the next time. It is possible with these stainings that are available for the ceramic systems to put them inside also. Yeah.
Okay.
And if you, for example, if you have a zirconium structure and you have your liner put on and fired on your liner, you can take your stains and paint the underground, and then afterwards you put your ceramic above. So you can get the color from inside. That's a very, very common method to bring a lifeful color, a lifeful tooth, if the color is coming from inside.
Okay. Thank you very much. I look forward to getting a better explanation of that probably in the next presentation. Probably something practical on porcelain.
I will look for the pictures, and if you like, I can offer to show you a bit about layering. I had it the last time I had this picture on the screen, but I'm not prepared for that question. So give me the time to do it for the next time, right?
All right, sir. Thank you very much. I'll appreciate that. Thank you very much.
I think now any other question, because we will not keep hands for too long. We are over 1 hour now. We would like to segment our session at least 1 hour, maybe 1 hour, 10 minutes. So let's ask more questions, and we can continue discussion on our YouTube over this, where we share this video. But however, it is good now that Hans is on ground. Ask questions so that we can learn more.
If there,
any question from colleagues?
If there are no further questions, what will I say? For sure, we have totally different conditions. In your labs, I don't know if you are very nice. For sure, we have. I don't know what kind of materials you have. I don't know nothing about your situation, about your life, about your culture. I don't know nothing about that all. And I would love to have more information about you, about the people, about the life. It's, for me, it's a very difficult situation now, because normally I go to the people and learn about them. And now I know nothing. I'm chemically clean, you know, about you and your culture. And I want to help you. What I said last time when we talked to you both guys, I'm 64 years almost, and I want to give a little bit back to my profession, what the profession has given me. I'm doing the job now since 46 years, and it's time to give back. Yeah, I have so much pleasure and fun in my job. We also have difficult situations. We have trouble with the dentists. We have trouble with the patients. Maybe it's the same you also have. But for me, it's still a fun to work, to go in my lab and doing, maybe there are people they can do it better, but why not? I try to do my best in my lab, and it's, for me, it's now it's time to give it back to the colleagues. And that's why I want to help you. And if you have any questions, please go to Olifemi and ask him if he can go in touch with me. If you want to have direct contact, it's no problem at all. You can ask me any day, any what you want to know, right?
Okay, thank you, Hans. I think by understanding what you said, you want to know us, I think there isn't so much that we can tell you about us. We are dental technologists from African countries. And some of us, let me say, most of those who are here today are students or those who are just finishing their programs from the school. And I tell you, what obtains in our practice is the relationship between dentists and the dental technologists, which I believe is same in many parts of the world, is the clinician, the dentist, takes care of the clinical aspect of practice. And our job starts from impression and all the job prescription that are placed on the job card and are sent to us. Now, if we have to make crowns and bridges that involve porcelain, which we majorly use do in Nigeria, our interaction or knowledge of color is not as expansive as you have just explained. Because I know I've seen a number of my friends who handle porcelain materials, and what they do is mix colors, and there's no explanation from the clinician that this is what the enamel should look like. No prescription. He just takes a shade guide, just the kind of shade guide that we use for acrylic tincture, and makes a color, and there you are. He produces a job. And I tell you, we don't have issue with colors so much in Nigeria. What okay. I meant by that is that our patients, I can hardly hear people, except when the color is so different, complain about color problem in our restorations. Because patient depends so much on expert advice. They prefer, they count on your experience on color. Except where there's serious divergence in their natural colors compare with the color of the restoration you make, that is when we can have problem. I tell you sincerely that the issue, we don't go in depth in our practice like this in a color, but you have really, like I said before, opened us up on colors, and you have gone in depth And you have taught us color more than we have ever been taught, even while in school. I think with that, about this topic, you will understand our practice about color, and that normally we don't have concern about colors in our practice. And therefore, we hardly have issues that patients would complain about colors in different practice from my experience. That is much I can tell you about ourselves. I don't know if there are specific areas of interest that you like to know about.
Yes, I would, for example, I would like to know what kind of materials you have. Because a lot of materials are made in Europe or in America, and I think it will probably such a ceramic system is pretty expensive here. Do you have the same materials like we have the complete possibilities like we have, or is it limited to anything? That's what I'm interested in.
Oh, okay. I think let me briefly answer that. Talk of materials that we use. Because about 90% of restorations that we offer to our patients is acrylic dentures.
Ah, okay.
Now, porcelain will take about 10%.
Okay.
Zirconia and all that, I'm not aware that we have it on offer in any of our laboratories in Nigeria.
Okay.
If we do have, maybe in some private places, some private laboratories. So our PFM, we use chrome cobalt, and then we use porcelain.
Okay.
So our practice is an imagined practice. And so when it's not as expansive as we have in Germany and Europe. In general, that is the extent of our practice as far as dental technology is concerned.
Okay, so let me think about the following for the next time. I can prepare this what I said about the internal staining and this that I can prepare, but it's not your most important topic. You have other problems, I see now. Yes,
okay.
You have problems with, for example, fully dentures, individualization of fully dentures, for example. This, you must earn your money. You must find your place in the market, right? And if you find a good place in your market, if you are able to do something exceptional, right? So I will prepare for the next time. I will prepare something about fully dentures, maybe setup of the dentures, maybe individualizing of the dentures, looking what is possible, what we can do in this space. We have different setup styles. I must talk with my daughter if she is assisting me a little bit. And I can explain, if you are content with it, I can explain different tooth lines we have. And what brands do you have in Nigeria? What brand of teeth do you have?
Amata, can you answer that?
I didn't get the question well. You said what kind of kits do we have in Nigeria, right?
Yeah.
Yeah.
What companies are delivering your teeth?
Oh, we have Ashade Dental. We have Medilox. Those are the two basic companies I know of that deliver acrylic teeth.
Okay, both I don't know.
Acrylic stock teeth. Yeah. Then the porcelain comes in, I can't really figure out well that company now, but I know there's
Vita.
Vita, that's right. Vita supplies that porcelain materials. And I think that's all we have in Nigeria for now. We haven't gone beyond that. We've not gone digital. We've not gone to Zirconia, any of those things.
Yeah. So this is, in so far, it is interesting to know, because it does not help you really if I bring anything what you cannot use. So
yeah.
Let us talk about things you can handle, you can use in your daily work. For example, if I show you individualization of setup for natural setup, you have no patience. You have a model, but if you get the right information, very simple photo of the patient, you can imagine if this denture you are setting up is fitting or not. Just a simple photograph you need, nothing else. Yeah, these are things I think they are more helpful for that than any theoretical part about ceramic, for example. I have a huge knowledge in ceramics, but it's not worse for you because you cannot handle it, right?
Okay, let me come in here and let me say something here. This group is prepared to advance beyond what we already know. Now, while we're happy to learn and improve on what we know from you, we also want to advance beyond that. Thank God for technology. We can see you from your lab now, and for that reason, we could learn more than we have ever known in order to advance, in order to have a motivation to improve on our training. So I don't want us to limit to what we are doing and how we can benefit from the experiences and improve on the experiences we already had. But we want to go into areas that are beyond our present practice so that the young ones who are just coming up could be motivated to advance in different areas of our field and be better for it. Let me also say something. Most of our products, since economic problem, come from China. That is why we cannot define sometimes these are specific things that we use. For example, impression materials come from China. You see different kinds of impression materials in Nigeria. You see different kind of stock teeth. A Vita is the only unique porcelain material that we can refer to. Others may come in different names. Even the equipment that we use, some of our equipment, unlike some 30 years back, when we import directly from Britain. Today, China has taken up the market, so names of equipment and materials sometimes are not pronounceable. And they come in different ways, and they have really influenced our practice in ways that we cannot match our experiences with what we have in Europe. But this platform is to help us to get back on track. So we want like to know more than we have already known. The other time you spoke with me, you said you want to do layering. And I think layering would be a good topic that will follow up the color that you have just taught us. Why not do that before you go into dentures? That is the question.
Yeah, that's okay. I can do whatever you need. I just had an idea. We spoke about colors, about painting, about surface painting, and we spoke about porcelain teeth. You know that these porcelain teeth can be modified in the color with the staining colors we have. Yes, but be careful. If you put on the surface any color, you get more gray. If you want to use that, use a brighter tooth to be able to adjust that. Yeah, you get a darker version. If you modify the color, you always get a tone darker. So take a tone brighter to be able to modify it, to individualize it. Okay. Yeah. Okay, so next time we will have a look in the lab, and I will prepare something for some layering, and show you the handling of a ceramic system, if it's okay for you. Shall we do
that? Yes, it's okay. I think what we need something that hands-on. I know you have your camera there. We can watch how you do the layering and listen to your explanation. How about that?
I must prepare the camera. I have a GoPro for my daughter. She is, as I told you, is an artist. She is doing commercials and something like that. And I take her GoPro and we will have a look on that afterwards. Okay. And I have some samples from any exhibitions. We have in Germany, we have the IDS. It's a huge international exhibition. I want to invite you, if possible, to share us next time. It's the next exhibition is in 2019 and in March. And in so far, if you find a way to come over, we had about 140,000 visitors this year. And that's a huge, huge, huge exhibition. You need more than 3 days to see that all what is possible. So if you can handle it anyhow, try to go out and have a look on other things. Yes, it is interesting.
Okay, great. I think 2019 is quite some time from now. We get ready. We may visit as a team. A team of maybe 3 or 5 men, and we will prepare and get ready for that time. Let me also say something. I know that some of my junior colleagues here who are students or just finishing school, they would like to have interest in having maybe some brief period of 1 week or 2 week, 2 weeks. Of experience. Can we be looking at that in future, maybe in your lab or somewhere?
Yeah, for sure. We have sometimes guests in our lab, and why not, if there is any interest? And yes, I had one colleague from Portugal, I had one colleague from Lebanon, I had it's why not? It's okay if you want to do this experience.
Okay. So I think I will discuss further with you online and through WhatsApp so that we can fine tune such a plan. But it is not something that is going to happen immediately because we haven't had anybody who has interest yet. Yeah. But anyone who shows interest will surely do that. Yeah. So we're expecting hands-on layering next time that we're going to be meeting. I would like you to, weekend is good for us and around this time. I don't know which weekend is okay for you to take us.
I must see, it's going to Christmas now and we have family issues and I don't know if it's possible to do it again this year. So be patient, please. We will keep in touch and it's not so much preparation for that. It's okay. For me, I have to go to the lab for sure for this hour or a little bit longer. It's no problem at all. I like to do that. But the actual problem, it's not a problem. It's a pleasure. My daughter is getting a baby next and I don't know when it comes.
Oh, wow.
I'm getting grandfather, yes.
That's great.
That's wonderful. Say good news.
Okay. I think no problem. I think we can wait and I will be chatting you on that and we decide when next you can meet. Guys, anybody, question from Hans in the next 5 minutes? Please go straight to your question. Okay, Hans, I think from what you can hear now, is some are not ready for us. I don't want to keep you because we have spent 1 hour, 25 minutes, and this is awesome. We appreciate this. We appreciate your sacrifice. We really thank you for your time. And I know you are ever willing. You've said it many times, and I'm happy that our path crossed. Thank you so much.
Maybe find us in Facebook. If you are in Facebook, we can see us there. And Olofemi, I will give you the link for the presentation. No, you already have it. You can share it with the members, with the participants from
yes,
this evening.
Participants.
And they can repeat a little bit. And if there are any questions after that, please feel free to contact me. Okay?
All right. Yeah, we recorded this session, and we would like to have your permission to share it on the YouTube.
Okay. It's okay.
Okay. Okay. So we share it, and I will send a link to you after after this time, and we will let you see all that went all through this period. We appreciate you.
Some of my colleagues found me already in YouTube the last time you recorded it, and okay. They found me and were astonished. What are you doing there?
Yeah. Oh, that's good.
Okay.
So thanks so much, Mr. Amateo. Do you want to have a word of bye-bye to him?
Yeah, I must say something. I must say I'm so grateful for his time and audience. It's not been easy for a man of his age to come so low, stoop so low to our level. I must say I'm grateful. On behalf of the team, I'm saying a very big thanks to you, sir. We look forward to having more of you. And I know you'll definitely be there for us. And of course, as time goes on, we'll get to chat you all privately on our various grounds, and then we'll build a better relationship in future.
Okay.
Thank you very much.
You're most welcome. Dear colleagues, I wish you much success in your business, and I wish you a first nice evening.